Welcome viewers, in today's video lecture, I will make you familiar with parametric curves, spline representations and various terms related to spline representations like control points, like convex hull and interpolation splines and approximation spline and also the continuity conditions for splines. So let's start. First of all, the introduction means what are splines. A spline is a flexible strip to produce a smooth curve through a set of given points. Basically, it is used in drafting terminology where a long narrow strip or wood or strip of wood or plastic was taken and some weights were hanged on this strip to give it a shape of curve. When these curves are specified in computer graphics, then the same term is used in the computer graphics also, which is a spline curve. This term is used to define a type of curve that is specified with the help of some data points. So such splines have been used for designing automobiles, ship hulls, aircraft wings, and there are various other curved surfaces that are used that have to be designed in computer graphics, and all these are designed using spline curves. And also spline curves are used to create or design the animation paths. So you can see that these splines are very useful in computer graphics. All types of curved surfaces can be designed or created using splines, and with the help of splines we can also easily manipulate these type of curves. So what are the some requirements, because we need to specify these splines in mathematical terms, because after all we need to manipulate them using computer and we need to store these spline curves in our memory. So there are some requirements that we might like to have in our mathematical splines, how we are going to represent this splines. So predictable control must be there, means there must be some starting point and ending point for these splines. We must be able to specify the multiple values to create multiple spline surfaces, and a local control must be ensured so that we can change the spline locally and it will not affect the global spline, means the whole spline. It must not affect the whole spline. The changes we are performing in the locally, that should not affect the global spline, the whole spline. It must be versatile, so we can use it in multiple designs, creating multiple spline objects and surfaces and curves. And also a continuity condition must be ensured so that the spline curves are smooth. So these all are the requirements of spline. Spline curve is specified by giving a set of coordinate positions called control points. These are same as the weights that were used to provide the shape in the drafting terminology. So the control points are what? These specify the general shape of the curve. And also the spline curve is defined, modified and manipulated with the operations on the control point. We can restructure the shape of the curve by repositioning some or all of the control points. Basically, with the help of control points, we can initially create the curve, we can restructure the curve, we can perform various types of manipulations on the curve with the help of these control points. For example, we can translate the whole curve by translating the control points, by changing the position of the control points. We can rotate the curve by rotating the control points, as well as we can scale the curve by scaling the control points. So now these control points are fitted with piecewise continuous parametric polynomial functions, and we can fit them in one of the two ways. One is interpolation and other is approximation spline. So we create various curves and then we will fit these curves in with control points. So if the polynomial function is fitted so that curve passes through each control point, In the first curve, you can see in the first example that this curve passes through each and every control point. These black dots are representing the control points, and this curve is passing through each and every control point. And in the approximation spline, this curve is not touching any control point, so it is not passing through any of the control point. It may pass through one or two control points, but it necessarily need not to pass through each and every control point. Then it is called approximation spline. So in approximation spline, the curve need not to pass through each and every control point. And in interpolation spline, the condition is that the curve should pass through each and every control point. Interpolation splines are basically used to digitize drawings and specify animation paths, while approximation curves find their application in structuring the various object surfaces. So this is about convex hull. The convex polygon boundary that encloses a set of control points is called convex hull. Here you can see in this example, this polygon from P0 to P2, then P2 to P3, then P3 to P1, and then P1 to P0. Here a diamond polygon is there, a rectangle. This polygon is there. This polygon in which the curve, which is enclosing this curve, this is called convex hull. So this is the convex hull which is which encloses this curve. And in the second curve we can see that this polygon P0, P1, P2, this triangle, it is enclosing the whole curve. So this is the convex hull for this curve. What is the advantage of creating this convex hull? It provides us a measure of deviation of the curve bounded by the control points. Means this provides us the maximum deviation. The curve cannot go outside the boundary, outside this boundary of convex hull. So it provides us the maximum deviation of the curve. It also ensures that the curve smoothly follow the control points. So this is the control, this is the convex hull. The next term which is used in a spline representation is control graph, also called as control polygon and also called as characteristic polygon. What is control graph? Starting from the first control point, if we start making lines from first to second, then second to third and third to fourth and so on, from one control point to other control point, if we start making line, then we will get a control graph. In this example, if we make a line from P0 to P1, then P1 to P2 and then P2 to P3. This is the control graph of this particular curve. In the same way, in this example, this line from P0 to P1, then P1 to P2 and then P2 to P3. This gives us the control graph of this curve. This is basically useful in remembering the control point ordering. How splines are represented mathematically? The mathematical splines that we will use are piecewise parametric polynomial curves. We will see one by one all these terms in the sequence: parametric, then polynomial, and then piecewise. So first of all, start with parametric. In general, a parametric curve in the plane is expressed as x equal to xt and y is equal to yt. For example, a circle can be represented in two ways. In the parametric form, it can be represented as x equal to r cos t and y equal to r sin t. But as an implicit representation, the circle can be represented as x square plus y square equal to r square. Both are the representation of circle. But in case of spline curves in computer graphics, we are going to represent them with the help of parametric equations. That is, in the form of x equal to xt, y equal to yt. Now the next term, polynomial. What is the meaning of polynomial? A parametric polynomial curve is a parametric curve where each function xt and yt is described by a polynomial. Here you can see that x is equal to ai t to the power I. So powers are there and they are represented in the form of polynomials where I is from 0 to n. In the same way, y is defined as bi t to the power I. What is the advantage of using polynomial curve? The advantage is it is easy to compute. We can easily compute the curves in the form of polynomials, and also they are infinitely differentiable. Means we can find out the derivatives, first derivative, second derivative and third derivative and so on. We can find the derivatives of these polynomial equations. Now, what is the meaning of piecewise? Basically, the spline curves in computer graphics is created piecewise. What is the meaning of piecewise? Means first, the first piece is created from the first control point to second control point. A piece of curve is created. Then another piece of curve is created from second control point to third control point and so on. In this way, when all these pieces are created from first to last control point, then all these pieces are merged together, combined together, and we get a whole spline curve. So a piecewise parametric polynomial curve uses different polynomial functions for different parts of the curve. These polynomial functions are created for different parts of the curve, and after that they are joined together. So this is the meaning of piecewise curves. It is same as you have an iron piece. You have an iron piece and you have one more iron piece, and you want to join them. So using welding process, you can join these two iron pieces together. In the same way, the curves are created separately and then they are joined together. So as you can see, in case of welding process, when we join two iron pieces, there is some kind of abruptness, some kind of roughness when at the joint, some kind the joint, the smoothness is not there. So in the same way, when we join different pieces of these curves, we have to guarantee the smoothness at the joints so that the curve looks like smooth and curve look like one single curve. It does not look like that we have joined different pieces. So continuity conditions or continuity is very important in case of spline curves. So in the rest part of this lecture, we will look at the continuity conditions. So basically, what are continuity conditions? To ensure a smooth transition from one section of a piecewise parametric curve to the next, we impose various continuity conditions at the connection points. What is our requirement or what is our objective? That if we create one piece of curve and then we create the second piece of curve, we must ensure that while we are moving from one piece, one curve to the next curve section, then this transition must be smooth. This transition must not be abrupt. This transition must be smooth. This smoothness is guaranteed with the help of continuity conditions. We are going to impose these continuity conditions. There are various continuity conditions as C0, C1 and C2. C0, C1 and C2 are parametric continuity conditions. So let's see them one by one. Zero order parametric continuity condition is described as C0 continuity. It simply means that the curve should meet. First condition is that curves must at least meet at a joining point, at some common point. A common point must be there. This is the first curve section. This is the second curve section. And in this curve, only C0 parametric continuity is there. Only C0 continuity is there. So this is the first curve section and the second curve section. They are meeting at the same intersection point. So we can say that this curve is fulfilling the C0 continuity. That is, the values of x, y, z at the end point of the first curve section and the x, y, z point at the starting point of the second curve section, both are same. So by this we can ensure that the curves are meeting at same intersection point. Now we come to C1 continuity or first order parametric continuity. Here the condition is that the first parametric derivative of the coordinate function for two successive curve section are equal at their joining points. Basically, the first parametric derivatives represent the tangent lines. So the tangent lines of the two successive curve sections are equal at their joining point. Here you can see that the tangent lines are equal for both the curve section. So we can say that C1 continuity condition is meeting here. Now C2 or second order parametric continuity condition. It means that both first and second parametric derivatives of two curve sections are same at the intersection. Means the rate of change of tangent vector at joining point are equal for two curve sections. That is, the tangent line transitions smoothly from one section of the curve to the next. As you can see in all these three curves, here if you are moving from here to here, then the transition is not smooth. Here also the transition is smoother as compared to C0 continuity. But if we see the C2 continuity, then the tangent line is same. And in that case, the rate of change of tangent line is also same. So the curvature you hear is getting is very smooth. You can easily smoothly perform transition from one curve section to next curve section. So these are the parametric continuity conditions. By imposing these conditions, we can ensure the smoothness in the spline curves. There is one more type of continuity which is called geometric continuity condition. This is an alternate method for joining two successive curve sections. What is this method? It is that we specify conditions for geometric continuity same as we are specifying the conditions for parametric continuity. But in this case, what is the difference? We only require that the parametric derivatives of two sections are proportional to each other at their common boundary instead of equal to each other. In case of parametric, the condition is that the derivatives of two curve sections must be equal to each other at the joining point. But in case of geometric continuity, they may be proportional to each other at the intersection point. So we can say that the geometric continuity conditions are little flexible as compared to parametric continuity conditions. Now, in the same way, there are three geometric continuity conditions also which are generally used, and these conditions are G0, G1 and G2. So, G0 is zero order geometric continuity. In this, it is exactly same as zero order parametric continuity, means it only ensures that two curved sections must have the same coordinate positions at the boundary point. Or we can say simply that the two curve sections must meet, two successive curve sections must meet at the same common point. So G0 is exactly same as C0. Now we come to first order geometric continuity or G1 continuity. What does it mean? It means that parametric first derivatives are proportional at their intersection of two curve successive curve sections. They only need to be proportional, means there is no requirement that the magnitude of two tangent vectors are equal. The magnitude of two tangent vectors may not be equal. Then also we will say that the curve is following G1 continuity. Again, the second order geometric continuity or G2 means both first and second parametric derivatives of two curve section are proportional at their boundary. No need to be equal, they are proportional. G2 ensures that the curvature of two curve sections will match at the joining position. So curvature must match, there must be no abrupt transition from one portion to another. So what is positional or C0 continuity? Here you can see that this is the one polynomial function from one control point to another. And here you can see that this is the second curve. So these are two curve sections that are there in this curve, and you can see when you are moving, suppose this is a path and you are moving from first curve section and then you go to second curve section. So at the intersection point, you can see that there is a very abrupt change. You suddenly change the direction. So this is C0 continuity, which is ensuring only that two successive curve sections must meet. There is no smoothness. And then the C1 continuity, here you can see that this is the first piece of curve section and this is the second curve section. Here you can see the tangent lines. Here this tangent line is equal to this tangent line, and due to which there is a smoothness when we go from first curve to next curve section, then the transition is smoother as compared to C0 continuity. Now, what is the difference between parametric and the geometric continuity? To understand this, you must see the third example, which is again when we are moving from one curve section to next curve section, the smoothness is there. Smoothness is definitely there, but as you can see that the tangent vectors are not equal in the magnitude. They are proportional but not equal. This is larger and this is smaller, so they are not equal in the magnitude. So, but comparatively the transition is smoother as compared to C0. So these are the various parametric and geometric continuity conditions and spline representations. If you like this, please like, press the like button, also share my video and comment on the video so I can improve myself, and also subscribe the channel for more computer science stuff. Thank you very much.